And now to Augusta, where lawmakers are being asked to do something about robocalls. Those are the annoying calls made by computers that try to get us to buy something, or worse, scam us out of our money.
According to the telecommunications service UMail, the number of robocalls to Maine were non-existent, or was non-existent, in January of 2016. But each successive January, those calls have grown exponentially. Just last month, Mainers got 11 million of them. That is nearly 9 robocalls for every Mainer in a single month. Of those calls, just over 50% of them were from scammers. The rest were evenly divided between telemarketers and different kinds of alerts or reminders. So what, if anything, can be done to stop those calls?
Maine legislature is being asked to tackle the problem. Newscenter's Don Carrigan has that story from the State House.
This phone call from our department is to inform you that we just suspend your Social Security number.
A robocall allegedly from Social Security. I've gotten 3 of them in the last 24 hours. Apparently a scam. We all get many of these kinds of calls, and they are, at the very least, annoying.
I receive probably a half a dozen to a dozen phone calls a day from spammers and telemarketers.
Senator Justin Chenette wants the calls to stop. He's asking the legislature's Innovation and Development Committee to prohibit recorded or computer voice robocalls, except for police, emergency, or school messages, saying people need protection.
They don't want to answer their phones because it's the quantity of phone calls from out-of-state telemarketers and robocalls have gotten to the point where they don't want to pick up the phone, and that's just not okay.
The Attorney General's Consumer Fraud Office handles many of those complaints. AG Aaron Fry says passing a law might not stop all of them, but would send a message.
What this bill would do for Maine is it would provide a tool in the toolbox so that in the event that these callers are originating from Maine, Maine could take action. At the same time, a bill like this would also send a clear signal that this is a problem.
Chenette's bill and another would also target spoofing, using fake phone numbers to fool caller ID. And Senator Susan Collins says the federal government needs to take tougher action.
It is already illegal under federal law, but it is a case where the technology that can block these kinds of calls has not been widely disseminated by the telecommunications companies.
The Attorney General says people can sign up for the federal Do Not Call list, but even Collins says that's not stopping the calls, and Chenette agrees.
But we're seeing a number of states across the country getting fed up and saying, you know what, enough is enough. Our constituents, we need to protect consumers across their states.
There are many questions, including how far Maine can go to prevent calls coming from other states or even other countries.
If you want to decline this offer, press 1.
While the calls from everywhere keep coming. In Augusta, Don Carrigan, Newscenter, Maine.
So one question about the bill is whether it would also ban robocalls for or against candidates in political campaigns. Well, Senator Chenette says he thinks it could, but Attorney General Aaron Fry says that he believes political robocalls would not be prohibited because of constitutional protections for freedom of speech.